I continue to speak with myself, and now I will convince you to learn English, of course. Learn English a lot. No, I'm joke. Because I'm not going to convince you to do it, because if you don't, because of it, not necessary. You do it without any superfluous motivation. Okay, it's a little bit confused. I must to speak. Today I thought again about speaking technique, about speaking with camera, and I see that I don't do it every day. I find new reasons, and convince myself that today it doesn't matter. I will not do it today. I miss one day, I miss 2 days. I am procrastinating, and it's so pity, because I understand that I know that I must train myself, that I must speak with myself every day, 1, 2, 3 times, as much as it possible. But instead of that, I tell myself that no, I don't want to do it today. Oh no, my sleeping is bad, and it and the recording of video influences on it. I can't sleep because of it, and so on. It's silly. I understand that I must work, that I need to speak every day, that I need to use my English, to develop my English, work with my pronunciation, with my vocabulary. Yes, more, speak more. But it doesn't turn out so easy. I find reasons for how to say, I forgot this word. I'm trying to remember it. Excuse, excusion. Yes, maybe execution. Execution. No, don't fucking execution. Okay. And speak with you every day. Every day, tell yourself something in the camera. If you don't know what you should tell, just put it on. Just turn it on, and everything goes spontaneously. You will speak. You can speak stupidly, silly. It doesn't matter. The main thing to speak every day something. As I said already, you need to speak, you need to focus on time, not on speaking, not on thinking something sophisticated. Yes, you must focus on time. It's your time for practicing, for improvement, for development of your speech, of your language, of your English. It's time, 5 or 10 minutes, and doesn't matter what you will speak. The main thing is speaking. Turn on the camera and begin to speak. Right now I can speak a little bit better than I spoke before. I'm trained with dictaphone, I'm trained with thinking, I'm wrote every day one page or maybe more, and its influence on my speaking, of course, but I must expand my proximal zone of development. Yes? Zone of proximal development. Yeah, by Vygotsky. It's a great theory. I read it some days ago. It's very interesting. Zone of actual development, zone of proximal development, and zone of actual unknown. It means that I can't work with it, with there. I can't work there, but if I will jump into this zone and try to keep a balance. If I learn keep a balance in a known zone, it will be very helpful to improve my to expand my proximal development, my zone of proximal development. Okay, zone of proximal development. Concentrate on this. Now, my proximal development is the mastering of grammar speaking. I must speak more and more correctly. I must speak more and more correctly grammatically, and I must speak more and more correctly with pronunciation. Now I began to read a book about phonetics. I began to work with linguistic techniques. I listen a lot of material from linguistic about phonetics, about pronunciation, how to improve your pronunciation, how to work with your voice, with your sound. It's easy. I know it. I understand it. It's very interesting. For the lessons, I decide to work with new approach. I will explain everyone how my students maybe okay. I will explain my students how to develop new ability, how to develop their thinking, how to work with their thinking. For example, I can ask them, what do you need to improve your English? What do you need? And they can think and say, maybe I need study, I need learning. Yes, but what you need to learning? What you need for learning? And they can think again and say, maybe I need to improve my brain. Yes, I need to improve my memory, to improve my attention, to improve my memory, attention, imagination. Yes, of course, imagination is very, very important stuff with learning. And then I can ask them, how you improve your imagination? You can find this information in internet. You can put this question in searching and find a short video about this stuff. For example, how to improve my memory. You find a lot of information, and you can work with this information, and you will automatically improve your memory, your English, your thinking, and everything what you need to improve your ability. Okay, today I will speak about it with my students. Oh, the battery uncharged. No, uncharged. Yes, I am speaking. I have been speaking nine minutes, and the battery doesn't uncharge. It's very good because I can speak every time much more. For example, if I speak 5 minutes and doesn't enough to say everything what I want, but if I speak more, I'm warming up, and I can speak much more easier. I can speak about interesting stuff. I can find new thoughts in my brain, yes, but because everything what I am doing right now, it's find new thoughts in my brain, and I'm trying to get out of my brain their thoughts, and you using my voice, using my speaking. I'm trying to think in English. I'm trying to concentrate on English language and find new words that I can use to speak about something in the camera. Okay. Reading the phonetic books. It's books, grammar books. Grammar books is very painful, very boring. It's so difficult to read because you can force yourself to read grammar books. You can force yourself to read phonetic books, but it's very boring. If you will do it all time, for example, you have 1 hour per day to improve your English. And if you will spend 40 minutes for reading reading grammar books or phonetic books and learn to speak, to pronounce sound A, O, E, train it, it doesn't good idea. It isn't good idea because you tired from that. You tired from that, and it's very boring. This process stopping you from achieving your your goal because you don't want to do it. But if you find something interesting for you, if you learn English and find new information that helps you to improve your life, to think differently, to think different, to see on the world with other perspective, it's very interesting. You can find, you can learn new. If you get a pleasure from your thinking, from your learning, you won't do it more and more. And I think that you must invest in grammatic and in reading book very small time, maybe 5, maybe 10 minutes if you have an hour per day. Of course, when you achieve that level, when you can learn English 5 hours or maybe 10 hours per day, like I am doing right now, Yes, when you achieve that level, you can you can invest 1 hour per grammar, and you will find from that. But in the beginning, you need to concentrate on desire. Work with your desire. Work with your time. You can find a short period of time in your daily routine and try to increase this period of time. Try to think in English, speak in English, read in English, write in English. Do everything what you want. Do everything what gives you positive emotion, what gives you something that you want to give again and again. Okay, it's your linguistic appetite, it's your mental appetite. You work with it and you get a lot of from it, a lot of stuff that you can get from anything else, because it's much more amazing when you feel like when you feel that you have mental growth than when you feel like that you have strong growth, growth of power. Okay, the battery on charge, 15 minutes, it's very cool. I will speak again about everything, but I need to watch this speech and listen myself, try and make correct mistakes, okay?